Welcome to the vlog. It is another wintry day here in Calgary. I'm now leaving Calgary. Heading back to BC briefly. Tonight I got a show in Fernie, BC before I head back into Alberta for a couple more gigs. From today onwards, the next 5 days are all travel days for me, which sounds like a lot of work, but I love travel days. I love driving. You know me. This is what this whole vlog has mostly been about. It's been my music and travels because that's what I love doing. So only about a 3-hour drive from Calgary to Fernie, I think, plus whatever it takes for traffic. Big thanks to my friends and family who put me up while I was here in Calgary for 4 nights. As you can tell from watching the vlog, I had a great time, not only at my awesome gig last night at the King's Head Pub, but also just getting to explore downtown Calgary on Tuesday night when I got to see the Flames game. That was awesome. That's the thing about touring. You get kind of attached to cities for like 3 or 4 days at a time, and then you have to head out, but that's fine. And now I'm just bouncing around city to city, day to day for the rest of this first leg of the tour before I'm home for a little bit. So yeah. Should be awesome. 3-hour trip. Can't wait. I was just heading down the Highway 2 here, just south of Calgary. I thought I'd show you guys this awesome view. All flat here in Alberta, but with an awesome view of the Rocky Mountains in the distance. And that's about where I'm headed to Fernie, right in the heart of the Rockies. Can't wait. I'm now here in the cute little small town of Nanton, Alberta. Very cute, very picturesque view. This part makes me actually happy that I'm doing this in a kind of wintry setting, because it just makes the mountains that much more cool. Very nice, very small little town. Never been here before. I am here in the beautiful neighborhood of Crowsnest Pass, Alberta, where it is very windy and very cold, but I have to show you something incredible. All along the highway are these astonishing abandoned buildings that are remnants of an abandoned mine, all built around the turn of the last century and left there to rot away. Can't get any closer to them than this. It's the only one I was able to get this close to. So cool. I love the old brickwork. Can't spend too long out here because it is very cold and I need to get back on the road, but how amazing is that? So awesome. What a beautiful town this is. Wow, so glad I stopped for a second here. I'm standing here in one of the most humbling places I've ever experienced. This is the Frank Slide. They clearly built this road right over top of it. It keeps going for so far back there. We're just outside of the town of Crowsnest Pass. This happened 116 years ago in 1903, and I just can't even imagine the devastation. Absolutely obliterated the town of Frank. Goodness, took out the rail line. That's a picture of them rebuilding the rail line later that summer. Wow, all of this happened in 90 seconds. So in about the length that it's gonna take me just to talk about this event is how long it took to happen. Such a monstrous shift. Unbelievable. I seem to recall seeing the Frank Slide at some point as a kid and just being blown away by it. Wow. Sort of almost adds to it just seeing it all covered in the snow. Amazing. I literally just don't even have words to describe this. I've crossed over to BC now, and I'm in the adorable little town
of Sparwood.
Now, I'll be honest, it is a cute little town. It is a beautiful day, a snowy, wintry wonderland. But the real reason I pulled over was for this. This is the largest truck ever built. It's astonishing. I don't know if I'm really doing it justice right now. I should have... Well, I guess you can't get cars in here, but it would be nice to pull my car up beside it for comparison. But if you do want some comparison, I make it about halfway up this tire. I know that the rubber in these tires must be absurdly thick, but still, I would not go around carving my name into this thing. Can you imagine? I know that it's probably no big deal and that they're, like, many, many inches thick, but still, if one of those blew, well, I wouldn't want to be anywhere near this thing. Unbelievable. Now we've got some people for scale next to it, but this is crazy. Just never seen anything like it, perhaps because there is nothing like it. This enormous truck called the Titan was designed in the late 60s and finally built in the mid 70s. Now it toured around and did various trade shows. I don't understand how, but because this would be an absolute disaster to try to move this thing. But in 1978, it was sold to a mining operation here near Sparwood. It only was actually used in mining until about 1991. Being the biggest truck in the world, it can haul 350 tons worth of stuff. So, it's awesome. It was used till 1991. Afterwards, it was moved here and put on display. Alright, so I looked it up. It's technically not the largest truck in the world anymore, but it sure was when it was built, and it carried that title for 25 years or so before. In the late 90s, they made some slightly bigger trucks. So there are some trucks of that size working out in the mines. I don't know where, but for a long time, it sure was the biggest truck in the world, and it still is one of the largest trucks in the world. So maybe Sparwood can't quite hold that distinction anymore, but it's still an amazing sight to behold. I have arrived in Fernie, and just look at the view from where I'm staying here. Can't beat that. And how about this view out of my hotel room as the sun begins to set? It's a late gig tonight. I do not even hit the stage till 10 o'clock. Had to show you guys this. I'm in the old part of town in Fernie. The place I'm playing was established in 1908. Oh boy, look at how cool this place is. Super old school. And I'm playing at the pub right in the back. Look at this place. And here's my stage. How beautiful. This is gonna be an awesome night. Sure feel weird taking videos in a bathroom, but look at this. Even advertised that I'm from Maple Ridge. Oh joy.
Hey everyone. My name's Graham Strang. I'm from way over in Maple Ridge, BC, way the hell across the province. Gonna play some rock and roll, gonna play a lot of songs, you know. Gonna play some songs you don't know unless you're a huge Graham Strang fan. Gonna start with a couple that you definitely do.
Astonishing.
shine every day. Woo!
Thanks so much. Thanks, everyone. Woo!
And that does it. 3 hours and 2 encores later, I am done. What an amazing venue, what an amazing gig, what an amazing everything. I love this city, and it's such a shame that I can only spend one day here. Heading bright and early to Red Deer tomorrow, so I gotta get my sleep, gotta go to bed. Thank you so much for watching. Check out my description for a full list of all my upcoming concert dates, as well as links to where you can find my music, where it's sold or streamed online. Like this video if you liked what you saw, subscribe to my channel if you've been enjoying all my videos, and you can even ring the notification bell if you want to be notified every time I upload a new video, which should be tomorrow, and most days for the foreseeable future. Thank you so much for watching. Catch you with a new vlog again tomorrow. See you then.